Let us see this question. Find the Laplace transform and region of convergence of following signal x of t is equal to e power minus a t into u of t. So first, what is the given signal? The given signal x of t is equal to e power minus a t into u of t. What is the nature of signal? This is exponentially decreasing signal. Because it is multiplied by with u of t, the signal starts from t is equal to 0. That is what we learned from unit 1. So therefore, how to plot the signal x of t? So this is x of t versus t. So at t is equal to 0, its amplitude is 1. It decreases exponentially like this. So at t is equal to infinity, its amplitude will become 0. What is the nature of signal? E power minus a t into u of t. So this is the given signal. So let us find out the Laplace transform of the signal. The Laplace transform, what is the given signal? Lt stands for Laplace transform. Laplace transform of x of t. First, let us write the bilateral Laplace transform definition. Integral minus infinity to infinity. Just substitute x of t in the definition. And what is the transformation? E power minus st into dt. So this is the bilateral Laplace transform of x of t. What is x of t? Just substitute x of t. Integral minus infinity to infinity. What is x of t given? E power minus at into u of t into e power minus st into dt. So because of u of t, we have to take the, because u of t exists from t is equal to 0 onwards, let us change the limits from 0 to infinity. E power minus at into e power minus st dt. So we can find out the answer here itself, but in order to find out the region of convergence, let us substitute s is equal to sigma plus j omega. So therefore, to find ROC region of convergence, substitute s is equal to j omega in the above formula. So therefore, what is this? This can be written as integral 0 to infinity e power minus a t into e power of minus sigma plus j omega t into dt. So let us separate these terms. Integral 0 to infinity e power minus a t into e power minus sigma t into minus e power minus j omega t dt, which can be also written as integral 0 to infinity e power of minus sigma plus a into t into e power minus j omega t dt. So what is this? It clearly observe what is the, this is the definition of Fourier transform of this function. For this integral to converge, this function must be absolutely integrable. So therefore, for the above integral to converge, this function, that is integral 0 to infinity, what is that function? E power minus sigma plus a into t dt must be less than infinity. This function must be absolutely integrable. That is what we have written here. For this integral to converge, this function must be absolutely integrable. Okay. Now, you can see that for this integral to converge, from simple mathematical knowledge, so therefore, this sigma plus a must be greater than 0. So then only the answer for this integral will converge. So therefore, for the above integral to converge, from the above, what is the condition? Sigma plus a must be greater than 0. So then only this integral converges. For example, sigma plus a is equal to 2. This integral converges. Sigma plus a is equal to 3. This integral will get finite value. Like that, when sigma plus a is greater than 0, then only this integral will get finite value. If you substitute sigma plus a is equal to minus 1, this integral reaches to infinity. So this, if you substitute sigma plus a is equal to minus 2, again this integral reaches to infinity. So therefore, for this integral to converge, we have to take sigma plus a must be greater than 0. or we can also write it as sigma must be greater than minus a. Sigma, what is the name of sigma? Sigma is the real part of S, must be greater than minus a. So this is the region of convergence for this problem. Real part of S must be greater than minus a. So therefore, how to represent this in S plane? How to represent this S plane? So let us take the S plane. So this is the S plane, very important plane of this chapter, 0. So this is sigma r, we can also call it as real part of S. So this axis is called as imaginary part of S, r j omega r, imaginary part of S. So we have to take minus a here. So because this is the real axis, this is minus a. Just what is the region of convergence? Region of convergence is greater than, what is the answer we get? Real part of S or sigma must be greater than minus a. So therefore, you have to clearly mention, so this is the region of convergence. So this is the region of convergence. So this is the region which is greater than minus a. So this is the region of convergence for this problem. This is the region of convergence for this problem. So let us find out the Laplace transform of this. So that is Laplace transform of x of t. So what is the integral? That is 0 to infinity. So take the earlier integral, e power minus a t into e power minus s t dt. So where we have substituted s is equal to sigma plus j omega to find out the region of convergence. Now let us find out the answer of this integral. So integral 0 to infinity e power of minus s plus a t into dt. So what is the answer of this integral? Minus 1 by s plus a, e power of minus s plus a into t. Substitute the limits 0 to infinity. So 0 to infinity. If you substitute the upper limit, e power minus infinity is 0. If you substitute the lower limit, t is equal to 0, it will become minus 1. So it will become 1 by s plus a. So therefore, this is a very important formula of the chapter. Therefore, what we can write? E power minus a t into u of t's Laplace transform. The Laplace transform is 1 by s plus a. You have to clearly mention for every problem region of convergence. What is the region of convergence? Simply remember, s is equal to minus a. Because of u of t, it will come right side. That means real of s greater than minus a. So this is the answer for this very simple and very important problem in the examination.